Europe is facing its biggest migration crisis in decades. In response, the European Commission has doubled its emergency funding to 50 million euros, providing assistance to countries on its borders. But with almost 50,000 migrants arriving in Greece in July alone, the EU's foreign policy chief has been asked if more should be done.
We have to realize that the blame game is not bringing any kind of positive result for any of us. The main point is not saying who is doing his own work or not. The point is how do we face together the challenge and how do we manage together the issue.
But the pressure on the EU's borders is mounting. The former Yugoslavian Republic of Macedonia has in recent days been flooded with migrants from Greece. Their response is to transport them as soon as they can to neighbouring Serbia as the migrants head for Hungary. So far, the so-called managing of migrants seems to be limited to moving them on.
So hi, my name is Jacob Richards, and I'm going to explain to you the changes of the European Union on migrants and fences. A little overview about what the presentation is going to cover. It's going to start out with the past of the European Union and how it changes to the current European Union. The presentation will consist of the European Union, the Schengen Agreement, the migration crisis of 2015, and the European Union's response to that migration process, or migration crisis. A little overview about the European Union. It was founded in 1993 and consists of 28 member countries. It was known as the Steel and Coal Union before, or the Steel and Coal European Union before. One of their main goals is promoting human rights. It's very big to them. The Schengen Agreement occurred in 1985 between five European Union members. France, Germany, Belgium, Luxembourg, and the Netherlands all came together and signed an agreement. It called for the knockdown of borders inside of all five of these countries, so each citizen of these countries could travel across all five of them without any burdens or obstacles in their way. In 1995, the Schengen Agreement was put into effect by the European Union over the rest of the European Union. With internal borders, as it pertains to the Schengen effect, it eliminated any of the internal borders and allowed free travel for any of the citizens within the European Union across the European Union. And it eliminated any of the border checks from within the European Union and just allowed these citizens of the European Union to travel freely. The security checks at airports and seaports were also very minimum security, and you could only use these security checks to verify a person's identity or who they were. So again, very minimum security levels within the European Union. With regards to the external borders, there was a common external border and it spread across the whole European Union. There were minimum checks for the European Union nationals or the citizens of the European Union, and again, it was very minimum and low for security. For non-European Union citizens from other countries, they must present travel documents, and these travel documents consisted of why they were there to go into the European Union or what was their purpose, and they also had to have a visa with them. The external border should remain open for people who are touring or coming to the European Union to visit. It's very high attraction, the European Union, for tourism. People that are looking to travel for business, the European Union does business with or countries or businesses within the European Union do business with other countries outside of it. So they have to travel for these business meetings and such. People that are looking for work, they always want people that want to come and make their community and their union a better place to be. They also are for people who are seeking refuge from war or persecution, just trying to give them safety and a place where they can raise their family and live a good life. In 2015, there was a very large migration crisis. More than 1.3 million migrants and refugees from Syria, Iraq, and Afghanistan, the main three, sought refuge or sought asylum in Europe, specifically the European Union. Causes of these migrations were the Syrian civil war, which has been going on since 2011, and the growth of ISIS, who is a terrorist organization in the Middle East that has been has done many violent acts in the past years. The increase in attacks by President Assad's forces are also one of the reasons. They're, again, another very violent man that has brought terror to the Middle East and the areas where these countries are from. A couple of the responses by the European Union to the migration crisis. The European Union was very divided on how they should handle this situation or what each country should do. Germany has welcomed over 1 million refugees since 2015. They're at the top of the list for countries who have taken in these refugees and migrants. Sweden was also second on that list, and they had a very high number per capita. They've taken in a lot of refugees and migrants. The European Union also set quotas for the number of refugees and migrants for each country. And even though they were very small for some others, I mean, they're still trying to spread out the migrants and refugees as best they can so they're not all in one country at one time. The European Union also made a deal with Turkey, and what that was is these migrants and refugees coming up through Greece, if they wanted to seek legal asylum in the European Union, they had to apply for it. And if they were not wanting to apply for it, then they were deported back to Turkey, or deported to Turkey. Again, if they wanted to apply for asylum in the European Union but got rejected, then they were also deported back to Turkey. Also, members such as France and Hungary, Bulgaria, Macedonia, especially in Greece, they built fences to be able to protect themselves from these migrants and just keep them out of their countries. Here's a map that shows these fences that were built. You can see definitely in Macedonia near Greece, there's a very large number of fences because that's where these migrants and these refugees are coming up through. So you can just see that these borders in between the countries, so these are the fences and walls they built. Here's a bar graph that shows the Europeans' attitude towards Syria and Iraq and if they feel any major threat from these refugees and migrants. As you can see, Poland and Greece and Hungary and Italy are all at the top. They are some of the main countries that these migrants have been working their way up through to the European Union. And I definitely have the highest percentages that feel a major threat. Here's how a number of Europeans feel that these migrants, refugees, how they make their place to live. Greece, Italy, Hungary, and Poland, again, very high on the list, and they think it makes their countries definitely a worse place to live with the refugees and migrants. So the European Union has been turning migrants and refugees away. It's very unlike what they started with the Schengen Plan. They were very welcoming and never really turned anybody away and would always help. The European Union countries also want stronger borders. They're building walls and fences to ensure their safety and protection from these migrants and ensure that they're not coming into their countries. It's very unlike the Schengen Plan at first when it was no internal borders and their borders were only on maps. So very different from the past. The European Union is also divided on how to control this issue of the migration crisis. They're very divided on how to control this migration crisis, and I think it just shows a change from the past where they were united as one and they had one common goal, but now they're divided, and this shows the difference between the European Union's changes on migration or migrants and fences from past to present. Thank you.